So it's really hard to push the clutch down far enough to disengage it all the way to get it in first gear and reverse gear. So as you notice, she's not sagging as much. I've jacked her up and she's 6 inches higher than she was on this side, and still probably an inch lower than she needs to be. But now we got lots of space so the clutch doesn't hit the floor anymore when I'm pushing it. So there's nothing there, I just lifted the carpet up and I've grabbed myself a few random scraps of iron, and I'm going to make a bracket that welds across the top and then it's got an angle coming across the bottom that comes all the way across here. And since there's nothing underneath to support it with and it has no door, well, what I'm thinking is weld that vertical member, and that's structurally sound, hinges are strong, and then that'll go to the U-channel metal, and that'll be my little support bracket for underneath the frame to support the U-channel. Got my trusty Miller and a bottle of beer, so let's start counting time. Who needs clocks at Day's Farm? When you're out of beer, you know the day is done, and you work long and hard.
Looking good. Now I gotta get the torch and chop that off. Doesn't look stock, but it's gonna work out real good, I hope. Should be strong enough. A little corner brace and I think we'll all be set. Looks good to me. Where am I gonna put my beer? Damn it!
Well, typical. It's done. We're only deep into our first beer. And I've got some good strong corner bracing with some spring seal, which is a lawnmower blade, because in David's Farm's structural repairs, lawnmower blades are always necessary. They're used throughout my building, but actually not in the ceiling, but here and there. Even my motor mounts in my diesel minivan are made out of lawnmower blades. Yep, they're pretty tough. If you got something that always keeps wanting to break, just chop up a lawnmower blade. You can bend and form them with heating them up with a torch. And for structural support, well, that did the job for a corner brace. Everything's welded good and solid. So let's lower the jack and see if the body sags. We'll use that point as a reference. Did lower, maybe a quarter inch. Alrighty. They're ready for another romp. Try her out again. Look how high that pedal is now. Got to be about 8 inches compared to like 2 inches before. Just got to put the floor mat down to cover all the nasty things we don't want anybody to see. Of course. There we go. Yep. Complete with apple leaves. Nice and square. Notice now it doesn't have that crooked list anymore to the front end. Of course, the driver's side wears out more as you get in with your slushy, salty boots, and it rusts the floor from the inside out. In addition, of course, with this usual spray that comes off the front wheels. So let's take her for a test drive. You still got to watch out. The first step is a Lulu. A little dark in the shop. Alrighty. Wait for the glow plug thingy. Here we go. Come on, bitch! Yes! Aw, I got no rear view mirror. Oh well. Clutch feels really good now. We'll see if she engages in first, no problem, because she wasn't before. Oh yeah, and reverse. Yep, problems are solved. Okay, we're motoring. It is hard to drive a standard, you know, with a camera in your hand. Totally feels different now. Feels like when I first got it, before she completely collapsed. Oh, God! There's some big ones out here. Shifting with my left hand. Working real good. Wow.
We're gonna have fun on the Labor Day weekend, that's for sure.
Now I got pretty much everything working.